Sabin, Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The sake of those whom we have not met, my name is Venerable Canon Patrick Jalong Nuven, and I love the Lord as my personal Savior. Today is the first Sunday in Epiphany, as we have read or we have prayed in the collect of the day. And sometimes we just mention without understanding. Some of us may not understand when we say we are in the first Sunday in Epiphany, because the Anglican Church has a calendar and there are festivals or festive days that we celebrate, and also we are guided by those festive seasons. And I felt it is good to mention, because it is part of my sermon, what Epiphany is. An Epiphany is a season or feast that reminds us the different situations in which Jesus was shown to the world as the Son of God and Savior of the world, as well as the wise men who represented the non-Jewish Jewish world. The word Epiphany comes from a Greek word, Epiphania, which means manifestation or showing faith. It's a kind of manifestation, which means faith. And we as Christians should pray that Christ should manifest or show himself to us by speaking to our hearts for the renewal of our minds, so that we will also worship him better and present our bodies to him as living temple, holy and acceptable unto God. And that is why, when if you listen to the collect of the day, it was calling us and we are praying God that he may teach us or now to follow and obey Jesus Christ himself when he is manifested in us. For those who want to follow, I'm preaching from the second reading, that is from the Epistle of 1 John chapter 5, 6 to 9, but I'll go up to 13, because there is no way we can do without the text after. And when you look at this epistle, John or the apostle has been addressing the matter of authentic Christianity. The matter of authentic Christianity. This was because false teachers had caused confusion in the church and had left taking a number of people with them, as it has been happening even in today's church. People come with their own interests and they try to teach and to quell the word of God to suit their interests, and they teach something which is not according, which is not based on the Bible or the faith we have been taught. And also those false teachers claimed to have secret knowledge about Jesus Christ, but their teaching contradicted the apostolic witness to Christ. Remember, John comes in as a live witness because possibly he was there even during the crucifixion of Jesus. And this is why John himself is talking about and saying that it was not only blood, it was also blood and water. And that is why it is being testified to us. And God himself testifies and confirms that Jesus Christ is his loved son, and he has come to reconcile the world with himself. John repeatedly shows that authentic Christians believe the truth about Jesus Christ. They obey God's commandments and they love one another. Those who believe in Jesus Christ, those who follow God's commandments, they love one another. And that is the authentic Christianity. And remember, I had not mentioned my theme, or our theme for today is authentic Christianity, or the true Christianity. Those who have faith in Christ, and those who believe in Jesus Christ, they follow God's commandments and they love one another. Therefore, it is evident to us that there is no option, despite what come our way, we must love one another. As Christians, as followers of Jesus Christ, we must love one another. John wants us to have sure foundation for our faith. And also, he wants us that we understand the person of Jesus Christ, and authentic Christian faith rests on God's testimony to the person of Jesus Christ. And remember, previous Sundays and even during the Christmas season, we saw and we witnessed the Holy Spirit coming on Jesus and God himself speaking and confirming, "This is my beloved son." And we need to follow that witness of God himself to his son, Jesus Christ. This can only be obtained when we believe in God's trustworthy witness to the son, which gives us sure foundation of our faith. Because if we don't trust that, we have no sure foundation. We have no basis of our faith. And when you look at today's text, John 5, 6 to 9, John shows that God has given a trustworthy threefold witness to his son. Then in chapter 5, verse 10 to 13, he shows that believing God's witness, what God confirmed to us when he spoke through the Holy Spirit to his son, gives us that sure foundation for our faith with a aim that we may know that we have eternal life. Because it is in this Jesus Christ that we obtain eternal life. John outlines three benefits as believing God's testimony to his son. That when you have this faith and you believe in what God confirmed to us, you will have three good benefits. That it gives us inner witness, and those who disbelieve his testimony, they say that God is alive. That is what John is saying. Those who do not believe that Jesus is not the Son of God, they call God a liar. And we as Christians, we must have that faith. Believing God's witness to his son gives us eternal life. When you believe in that Jesus is the Son of God, as God confirms through witnessing to us, you have eternal life. John sums up God's testimony in verse 12-13. God has given us life through Jesus Christ. There is no other way. As a believer, as a Christian, you can have life without Jesus. This life is in that Son, that is Jesus Christ. And he who has the Son in him, all has life. And who does not have the Son has no life. If you don't have Jesus Christ in you, you don't have life. Even if you are living, another polite way. John is telling us that you are dead before God. Therefore, it's up to you to take up that faith and trust in Jesus Christ and in God's testimony. The truth of this matter, in believing the testimony of God to his Son, is that first, eternal life is God's gift. It's not something that you can earn. You cannot earn eternity. Not something we can gain through our good works, all efforts. You know, we do a lot of good works. We make a lot of efforts to serve the church, to serve other people. But it is the high time that we need to understand and know it clearly. It is a gift that we obtain or we get from God. It does not require some special secret or understanding or knowledge as the heretics taught. Some teach that even today, that when you do good works, and you know sometimes that is where we make mistake, especially those of us who sit here or those who speak to you. So at times we may fail to tell you the truth, maybe because you give good money to the church and we must receive it, but not to earn it. You cannot earn it in any case. Second is that God's gift is eternal life. Nothing else that God can give you apart from eternal life. Nothing could be a greater gift, because even the Bible asks, what will happen even if God gives all the wealth of this world? He gives you all the authority over the world and you miss eternal life. Will you have anything? You'll have gone to waste. Therefore, we must be careful and know that because of our sins, we were spiritually dead. Because of our sins, we were spiritually dead. And also separated from the life of God. Alienated from the life of God. When we were sinners, and even today, those who are sinners, they are separated from the life of God. They have no life with them. God gives us as our present possession not only an ending life, but also his very life. He gives us his own life because God is the author of life. You yourself, you cannot give life. None in this world can give life. And may I say this, brethren, if the power to breathe was given to human beings, some of us here cannot breathe. Yes, cannot breathe. It will be limited to you. And then the way you will behave, okay, you are behaving like this. Mr. Vickers, what? This is how you are doing to me. Tomorrow you are not breathing. And that is why God himself, when he was distributing some of the authorities, for we are created in the image of God himself, he kept some to himself. Because he knew He left some powers to himself. As he was telling us to overrule or to rule the world. He distributes wealth according to his wishes, according to his will, and even according to our abilities. Therefore, we must know that God's gift is eternal life. He is the holder of life. Jesus himself promised that if we believe in him, we will never die. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Because you will not die.
Amen.
If you believe in Jesus. For those of us all fear death. And if you listen carefully, the first reading from Exodus chapter 14, Moses was worried when he was taking the children of Israel to cross the Jordan River. And the children of Israel were also fearing. And that is why they were questioning Moses. Were there no graves in Egypt that you have brought us to this wilderness? That we are now about to enter the sea. They were fearing there. Nothing else. But God calls Moses and tells Moses, why are you calling me? Tell the children of Israel to cross over. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Moses ended up in pain, and he was very much obedient to the commands of God when he was told to heat the water. He did it, and the water separated. And the Bible says that there were wars on the other side and on the other side. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Therefore, there is life in God. And those who believe in his son will not and will never die. In other words, physical death will not rob us of this eternal life with God. Because the Bible says, even if you will die, you will come back to life. And you will come back to eternal life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when you know that, you live in this world with joy, without any fear, knowing that even if death comes, even if physical death comes, it will not rob you your physical, your eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
The third thing is that Jesus Christ is everything. Hallelujah. You know, as the year begins, each one of us is facing a different challenge from one another. Some of us have loans that are worrying us. Some of us are worried we don't have school fees. Some of us are worried about how to go over the jail. Some of us are worried my family has no peace. Some of us are worried I have lost my job. Some of us are worried my business is going down. Now John is coming in and telling you that Jesus is everything.
Amen.
If you trust and believe in him, that what is worrying you, Jesus Christ will give you in a special way, in a miraculous manner. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, I read in Deuteronomy 28, which talks about when you obey the commands of the Lord. The Bible says that if you trust in him, the blessings will come to you. You will not go to search for the blessings, but the blessings will come to you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Whatever you want will come to you as much as you have faith in Jesus Christ. If you don't have Jesus Christ, you don't have life. You know, there are people who say there is no life here. And life is experienced with different aspects. When I talk of life now, I'm not talking about now the life in us. I'm talking life on other aspects. When you say there is no life here, You go to an hotel, you say, I won't go back to that hotel. There's no life there. I'm walking out of this marriage, there's no life here. Have you had people say that?
Yes.
And even others have said, there's no life in this church. When you say there is no life in the church, it is you who has no life. Because Jesus Christ gives life and life in abundance.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And if you have just Jesus, you will find life. All God's promises are yes and amen. And they are true in Him. If Jesus says you, if God says He will bless you, even if somebody tries to block you, he or she will not penetrate. Because God has said He will bless you. And it is true, God has said He will bless you. Only that if you follow and obey His commands. All that God offers to us, He offers in Jesus Christ. Through Jesus Christ, He is the only sure, solid foundation of our faith. All that God offers, there is nothing in this life you can attain, you can get, you can achieve without Jesus. So my dear sister, my brother, I'm urging you that you receive this Jesus, you believe in this Jesus, that you may get God's promises, that you may receive God's blessings, that you may receive life in Jesus. The name of God the Father is Father.